Is AMD really doing its best to compete with NVIDIA GPUs when it comes to AI and provide the most value to its customers? This question concerns both the hardware, the GPUs, and the software. As we'll see, the software has a much greater influence. In today's video, we're going to break down AMD's approach to AI, their ROCm platform, and compare it to NVIDIA's CUDA dominance. Let's see what's really going on. In 2007, NVIDIA released the initial version of CUDA, Compute Unified Device Architecture, for both Windows and Linux. CUDA allowed GPUs to be used for general-purpose tasks alongside high-resolution 3D graphics tasks. This was clever as it positioned NVIDIA GPUs as a standard for scientific computing, making them the first choice for deep learning networks, AI, by 2015. AMD, meanwhile, tried two alternative platforms in parallel, but neither gained traction with developers. Their third and final answer to CUDA was ROCm, Radeon Open Compute, launched in 2016, a much later release compared to CUDA. To complicate things further, ROCm initially only supported Linux, though that's no longer entirely true, which is where the confusion begins. In July 2023, AMD announced ROCm HIP support for Windows. Many mistook this for full ROCm compatibility on Windows, but HIP is different. It's a tool designed to help developers transition their code from CUDA to run on AMD GPUs, not the ROCm AI libraries themselves. Moreover, HIP requires developers to actively modify their source code. It's not a plug-and-play solution. Worth noting, if you want to run AI on AMD GPUs locally under Windows, there are alternatives to ROCm like Vulkan. Vulkan is a cross-platform API for high-performance graphics and compute tasks. It's often used as an alternative to DirectX or OpenGL, making it versatile for tasks beyond AI. For instance, GPT-4all uses Vulkan to run LLMs like Llama 3.2. Well, due to a bug in AMD's Vulkan implementation that has existed for months, only Llama 3.0 works properly with GPU support. Llama 3.1 and 3.2 are actually slower on the GPU than on the CPU. The good news? Llama supports AMD GPUs on Linux and since March 2024 also on Windows. Their team uses ROCm HIP to achieve excellent performance. Here, for example, you see Llama 3.2 in action. So we don't have a problem using LLMs locally on Linux or Windows, but what about using AMD GPUs for image generation, particularly with Stable Diffusion and Flux? For AI image generation alongside other AI tasks, PyTorch plays a critical role. PyTorch acts as a bridge simplifying AI development, so teams don't have to work directly with CUDA or ROCm. That's why major open source projects like ComfyUI, Forge, and Automatic 1111 rely on PyTorch. It allows developers to focus on applications rather than GPU backends. However, PyTorch's GPU support isn't uniform. While it seamlessly supports CUDA on both Windows and Linux, AMD support is much more limited. On Linux, PyTorch works with ROCm. On Windows, however, developers must rely on DirectML, which has significant drawbacks. Severe memory issues, performance penalties up to 10 times slower than ROCm, and limited functionality. For example, PyTorch DirectML doesn't support advanced models like Flux or the GGUF format. An alternative is LUDA, which uses ROCm HIP on Windows to run more or less unmodified CUDA applications on AMD GPUs. I use it myself with ComfyUI and ROCm HIP 5.7 under Windows and it works surprisingly well. However, due to legal disputes, its future is uncertain. Additionally, native Rockham is faster, but it's currently only available on Linux. Despite these challenges, AMD hasn't prioritized bringing Rockham to Windows. Instead, they've released Amuse, a proprietary image generation tool based on selected models in the less popular ONNX format. But here's the problem. Amuse lacks the flexibility of open source tools like ComfUI or Automatic 1111, which support a wide range of custom models and far more features. Wouldn't it have been better for AMD to focus on bringing Rockham to Windows rather than developing Amuse? Recently, AMD introduced Rockham support under WSL2, allowing Windows users to run Rockham in a Linux virtual environment. But there's a big limitation. This only works with RX 7000 series GPUs and above. My RX 6800 didn't work with the initial driver version, and the second driver version wouldn't even install because my GPU wasn't supported. This raises the question, will Rockham ever come natively to Windows? And if it does, will older GPUs like mine even be supported? Nvidia typically offers longer support cycles compared to AMD. For example, older Nvidia GPUs continue to receive driver updates while AMD tends to drop support earlier. This disparity affects both gaming and AI workloads. Look at this table. My old Nvidia RTX 960 from 2015 with its Maxwell chipset is still supported by the latest CUDA 12.5. Meanwhile, AMD's RX 5000 series from 2019 to 2020 isn't even listed in the Linux support matrices for Rockham versions 6.3 and 6.4. Comparing GPU performance for AI tasks is not straightforward, especially when different platforms are used. In one performance test involving image generation using Stable Diffusion, the authors tested NVIDIA and AMD GPUs. For NVIDIA GPUs, the tests were conducted using CUDA, but for AMD GPUs, they used DirectML, one of the least optimal choices for AI tasks. Unsurprisingly, the AMD GPUs performed significantly worse than the NVIDIA GPUs running CUDA. However, I found a more balanced test in the ComfUI discussions on GitHub. This test consistently uses the same model and workflow. In it, my AMD RX 6800 with Rockham on Linux performed slightly worse than an NVIDIA 3060, a GPU that was much cheaper at launch and ranks far below the RX 6800 in gaming benchmarks, according to Tom's Hardware. This highlights a recurring pattern. For AI workloads, NVIDIA GPUs usually outperform AMD GPUs at similar price point. While the situation is different for gaming, the gap in AI performance remains significant. Since you've watched the video this far, this topic probably affects you personally. If you have suggestions for how we AMD users should deal with the situation, drop them in the comments. If you don't have a keyboard nearby, leave a like. A little light at the end of the tunnel. In a few days, I'll release an updated tutorial on setting up Rockham on Linux for tools like ComfUI. It's shorter than my old video and uses current versions of Rockham and Ubuntu. I'll also compare Rockham on Linux to Zluda. Don't miss it, hit subscribe and ring the bell. In the meantime, check out my earlier video on creating an Ubuntu USB drive. It's a quick and easy way to get started.